As a new investor, it can be overwhelming the amount of information out there on the internet. One thing I struggled with when beginning my investment journey was deciding which stock or ETF to buy. When brokers such as Trade Republic offer over 11,000 stocks and ETF options, you want to be choosing something that would maximize your profit in the long run. When I started on the journey of index fund investing, choosing an ETF looked confusing due to a few factors. The first one I already mentioned was having to choose from thousands of ETFs. Another factor was having many new concepts to get acquainted with, such as replication, tracking error, and distribution type.
There were also lots of unknown acronyms like DER, ISIN, NAV, KIID.
I didn't understand what any of that meant. But I am here to tell you that choosing an ETF does not have to be complex. In this video, I will be mentioning my process for choosing one, and what I have learned so far that could help in narrowing down the decision to buy a specific ETF. This is the Bullish Aristocrat. And in this channel, I would like to share my investing journey and give you all the tips and advice I wish I knew when I first started investing. So if you find that interesting, then please subscribe to the channel and like this video to help support us in reaching more people. Make sure to press the notification button to stay up to date with new videos that will be uploaded. So without any further delay, let us get started. The first thing to decide when you are choosing an ETF is determining the type of asset class you wanted the ETF to track. What does that mean? Different ETFs track different markets. There are ETFs that track the US market, others track global markets. By doing this step, you can narrow down the amount of possible ETFs from thousands to dozens. A very useful website I usually use is called Just ETF. I will provide a link below to their ETF screener. An ETF screener such as this one is an important tool to decide which ETF to buy. It can be very useful because it will allow you to see which alternatives exist for your criteria, and it will also give you all the relevant information you might need to know about an ETF. I want to show you an example of how I use Just ETF screener to select an ETF. Once you open the ETF screener, you will see that at the time of recording this video, there are 2,224 ETFs currently listed on Just ETF. This is a huge number of ETFs to select from. However, the sidebar on the left-hand side has useful filters to narrow down the ETFs to your preferences. The first filter I like to apply is the class asset filter. This allows me to select between equity, bonds, as well as the specific region I want to invest in. For this search, I will choose equities in the USA. You can see that just by applying this one filter, I've already reduced the number of ETFs from 2,224 to just 261. The next filter I like to apply is the fund size. It's the total amount of money that a mutual fund manager must oversee and invest. A large fund size would mean a lower expense ratio per person. You should select the funds based on your preferred risk level and return. There's no inherent reason that larger fund is performing better than smaller fund. For this example, I will use a fund size larger than 500 million euros. This filter reduced our search to just 90 ETFs. The third filter I like to apply is the replication type. I prefer to use a full replication method. This is when an investor simply buys an ETF that holds all of the same securities as the index they wish to track. We can now see that we have further reduced our search to 53 ETFs. The fourth and final filter I apply is the fund domicile. I prefer funds domiciled in Ireland to minimize taxes. And with all four filters applied, we had started with 2,224 ETFs to choose from and now we only have 44. You can further add more filters that would fit your search even closer, such as selecting which sector you want to invest in. You may not find an ETF that scores perfectly on all your criteria. You may have to consider some aspects more important than other. But the decision criteria will help you focus on the features that matter the most to you. There are probably other websites similar to Just ETF out there. But I personally prefer to use this one because it only shows ETFs which are available to European investors. The interface is also easy to use, as you just saw. And its ETF details pages have most of the information I use to make a decision on an ETF. In future videos, I will dive into some of my ETF holdings and explain more my reasons for choosing them. In conclusion, I showed how I use Just ETF to filter through thousands of ETF options to just a few dozen. By choosing the right criteria that you wish to invest in, you can reduce your search to even a handful of ETFs. It can be confusing and stressful as a new investor. But I hope to share more insight about my journey in this channel and hopefully help and encourage you to start your own. Thank you so much for watching the video till the end. Don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to the channel for more videos like this.